to Hello Hello. I'm Kat Iniba, and today we are in Kat's Kitchen, where joining us is acclaimed chef and cookbook author Farhana. Welcome, Farhana.
Thank you so much, Kat. Thanks for having me.
I'm excited because you're going to teach us how to cook a couple of Indian dishes, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the first one is chutney.
We are going to make a street favorite, samosas.
Okay.
And of course, with samosas, we always have chutney to go with it.
Yes.
Which is like the dipping sauce.
Right. But you said there's so many uses for chutney.
There are so many uses for chutney. Especially the version that I create turns it very much like into a dip. You can use it as a salad dressing on top of your salad. And then also you can use it for as a dip with your fresh vegetables. I do it all the time. I serve it at my parties with some fresh cut vegetables as a dipping sauce.
Okay, so what's the ingredients that we need for the chutney?
For the chutney, very simple. We have mint right over here, and we are gonna use some cilantro.
Right.
And what you do is you give cilantro a very coarse chop.
Okay.
You don't need to really chop it fine because it's all going to go in the blender.
Right.
Right? And then we are gonna have some regular onion, chopped up, you know, about 1/3 of an onion, one whole serrano chili, some lemon juice, a balance of sugar and salt, and we are good to go.
Okay, so what do we do? What's the first step?
Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to process everything.
Okay.
See, we make it simple, make it quick. In the olden time, they used to use that, you know, mortar and pestle of stone and all of that.
Yeah.
You know, technology makes our life very easy for us these days.
Yeah, especially because we're always on the go, right?
On the go, my dear, on the go all the time. So I have my mint already, you know, chopped up. I put in my cilantro. And then what you do to your serrano chili is, it's kind of hot, it's very hot and spicy. What you do is, you leave it whole. Just take the stem off, just like I did, and leave it whole over there. That's it. And your onion, about 1/3 to, you know, half an onion is fine.
Okay.
And then of course we have our lemon juice. And see, that is what gives it the tartness.
Right.
Your lemon juice is going to give it the tartness.
How many lemons did you use?
I use about 2 lemons are good.
Okay.
2 lemons for the quantity that we have.
Right.
Now you have, may I have a spoon, please?
A spoon?
A spoon will be beautiful. Thank you. So, you know, you can use any sweetener of your choice.
Right.
This is sugar, kind of said organic sugar. I like using the natural stuff, you know, and then a little bit of salt.
Yes.
And just to create that little balance, you know, you need to be, of course, going to be a little bit more with the sugar. And then you cover it up and just process it. And you can serve it actually, Kat, exactly the way it is.
Oh.
A lot of Indian restaurants, if you go to, you will see they serve it pretty much like it is.
Okay.
But here's what I do. What I'm going to...
That was really fast.
Okay. How long did that take?
Less than a minute?
There you go.
Okay,
there you
go. What do you do?
What I do is, so we'll put our chutney right over here. Take it out in a bowl. And to kind of, you know, to give it...
Oh, I love the mint smell.
Like
mint
the mint?
Cilantro, yes.
Mint and cilantro, it creates a very nice, you know...
Refreshing.
Sure. And again, you know, we want to make sure, do a little bit of a taste test.
Right.
You have a spoon over there?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
I'm always ready.
Okay. You're gonna give me another spoon. Let me make sure I have the sugar and salt balance good in here. That's good too. Are you good with spicy stuff?
Yes, I am.
You are?
Although you put that whole serrano chili in there,
whole
I'm a
serrano
little scared.
Chili. No, you're going to be fine.
Okay.
You're going to be fine, just a little bit, a touch little. And then I'm going to turn it into a dip, as I was saying.
Right.
And then I'm going to have you sample it once we have the dip done. To make my dip, I'm going to put sour cream in it. I'm going to put a little bit of mayonnaise in it and some yogurt.
Okay.
So make sure that it's blended smooth.
Right.
So there are no lumps in it. It, you know, blends in nice. And it really makes a little bit of a difference, you know, makes it a little bit easier to mix it up. So you have a yogurt over here. And you can leave it to sour cream and yogurt.
Right.
But I do add a little bit of mayonnaise. So it's optional.
Okay, what does the mayonnaise do?
You know, mayonnaise is going to give it that little... you know, consistency that you're looking for,
okay.
A little bit of richness that you're looking for, mm-hmm. right? And it's gonna turn it very much like into a dip. These are optional. You can just stick with the two that we have over here, mm-hmm. and you know, just a couple of tablespoons pretty much of mayo.
Right.
And just blend it in.
Nice and thick.
Right. And you know, there's no exact science to it. Mm-hmm. You go with the, you know, palette that is more pleasing to you.
Right.
And then you can make it as rich. And but you don't want to dilute it too much. You still want that nice mint flavor.
Yeah, that refreshingly
the nice cilantro,
mint.
Yes. Exactly. Cilantro flavor to it, you know.
And then is that it? That's all.
That's it. We are done.
We are done. Okay.
Sample it off, my dear. See what you think of it.
So I'm gonna just use this spoon. I'll grab you another clean spoon.
Okay, very good. Thank you.
Oh, it's very refreshing. I can't wait to try it with the vegetable samosas, right? But we're gonna take a quick break,
okay.
And then you'll show me how to make the vegetable samosas.
Absolutely.
Okay, don't go anywhere because Farhana is gonna show us how to make veggie samosas when we return.